It is a big responsibility to safeguard one of the world's most important natural resources.
O banco é uma garantia para a segurança alimentar do mundo.
Svalbard is certainly one of the safer places on the planet.
Obviously, we are seeing the effects of global warming, and that's creating some issues for the seed vault.
The further north you go, the faster the change happens. So I don't think it's happening so fast now that everyone can see it.
Around 2003 and 2004 was when the idea really came up and we started to talk with the Norwegian government about it. Our idea was pretty simple, and that was that we would take an abandoned shaft of an existing coal mine, we would make it a little bit bigger, and we would offer that space for countries to deposit duplicate samples of their seeds.
This is from the Australian pastures.
The vault itself is the repository. It's the safety backup for these collections from around the world. If you were to ask, well, I need some wheat diversity because there's a terrible rust that's affecting my crop, I need to do some breeding, you would go first to these international collections, and then it's those gene banks who send their materials to Svalbard.
If something goes wrong around the world, the idea is that you can go to the seed vault and retrieve material. And unfortunately, things do go wrong. An international gene bank that is called ICARDA, one of the most important gene banks in the world. It used to be based in Aleppo in Syria. And due to the war, they couldn't operate. They couldn't distribute seeds anymore to farmers and scientists and breeders. We decided to take seeds out of the vault.
So that they can reconstitute their collection that became inaccessible to them. It's already proven its worth in its first 10 years of existence.
We want to place the seeds in a safe place. We have few earthquakes, it is politically stable, there are not wars in the Arctic, and despite the fact that climate is changing, it is still one of the more secure places when it comes to a kind climate in the future.
Everyone sees the changes. They go faster the further north that you go. Already now it's about 3 degrees warmer than it used to be. There's more rainfall, also in the wintertime, unusual rainfall. And we get icing condition because it differs between minus degrees and plus degrees, and you get ice cover in larger areas, makes it difficult for the wildlife.
Wherever I look, I see change, quite dramatic change. This fjord behind me used to be frozen. This time of the year, we should have almost a meter of ice here. The open ocean waves crashing on the beach is something new.
Essa caverna aqui de Longyearbyen, quanto mais esquenta, mais vai derretendo o gelo. E ela vai formando canais mais e mais e mais fundo todo ano. Então, quando a gente entrou aqui para ver esse ano, ela tá bem larga. Quer dizer que tá rolando mais água durante o verão e os rios estão engordando na geleira e fazendo essa caverna ficar cada vez mais larga.
When the vault was constructed and this tunnel that leads into the vault where the seeds are was built. Everybody thought that the permafrost would come back, But due to climate change, that has not happened. So there has been a bit of water coming into the tunnel. There has been no water close to the seeds. But we want a completely waterproof construction and vault. So that is why the upgrading is going on.
Agriculture today faces a historically unprecedented combination of challenges, and number one on the list is climate change. Are we prepared, and are our crops prepared for climates that have not existed before, either in Brazil or whatever country you're in, or even indeed in the history of agriculture?
Wheat, for example, comes from the Middle East, and we now grow it absolutely all over the world. But it has taken 10,000 years, 10, 12,000 years even. So that's why we need to help them. And we need to breed plants that can stand higher temperature, tolerate higher salinity in the soil, for example.
Imagine the implications of one of our major crops failing in any region in the world, failing to adapt to climate change. The human cost internationally would be beyond estimation. So we have to be prepared for that, and the way that we get prepared is to save all the pieces, all of the diversity that contain the traits, the options that we'll need for future plant breeding.
The challenges that we face are unknown to a large extent today. The fewer surprises we expose ourselves and nature to, the better can we predict our own future. The odds are against us. There will be some winners, but most of us will be losing.